So I'm on the opposite side of Loch Etive and from Connell, on the road to Bonawe. I'm going to see a priory, but I've just discovered there's an ancient kirkyard. With a busy graveyard as well, quite an ancient one too. But I've just been informed from some chap that his property has been sold. The sale of the Ardchattan Kirk should not affect the cemetery in any way. Somebody's bought it. Oh, there you go. So, yeah, the kirk door's closed. I mentioned before in some of my vlogs that 700 churches in Scotland are closing. I mean, obviously, there's not many parishioners would probably use this, but it's very sad, isn't it? Well, it's very sad being in the graveyard, but what I mean is it's very sad to see all these fantastic buildings just going to wreck and ruin. But thankfully, this will be converted into a residential property. Mr. Donald Campbell died in 1899, aged 57 years of age. And, yeah, there's a lot of Campbells in Argyll, isn't there? There we go, so here's stone. So I'm going along this way now. I'm going along to the priory for a visit, and we'll see what's what when we get there. It's a very pleasant day. It's a very pleasant April day. It's not April, Annie. It's the last day of March, you fool. Look at the lovely Celtic crosses. Yeah, well. Yes. Anyway, this is the kirk here, so I've got its name. Just for the record, I've been here. Next time I see it, maybe somebody living in there. Right, so I'm going up to the ruins of the Ardchattan Priory. So it's not far to go. 100 metres, I think. 90 metres. Oh well. Ardchattan Priory. The carved stones. Most of the slabs in this shelter are of the late medieval date, but the one at the furthest left, this one here, stone one, is much earlier than the others, and it's carved in a very different style to the rest of them. It was probably carved during the 10th century and was originally intended to stand upright, possibly within a burial ground. It's pretty amazing stuff that's been carved. They're all amazing, actually. This is the priory. Look at these old stones, Annie. What an amazing place to have a place of worship in. Look at this. You see, what a beautiful, these people back in the 12th century, look how skilled they were to build all this from hand without any cement or concrete. This is all just stone. That's pretty amazing. So all this is just stone upon stone. And fantastic big, with castles and stuff, you know, it's amazing. Truly amazing. I think that people lived in here, eh? It's quite something. have a quick zip through here and Hugh Campbell died on the 16th of April, 1864, aged 60. God bless him. These ancient graves, Annie. This here is the crucifixion stone, and it's called the MacDougall Cross. It was carved out in the year 1500. The whole place is absolutely amazing. Very interesting, actually, Annie. What we'll do, because it's not a lot of take footage of. But what I think we'll do is we'll do a little bit of search into the place and we'll do a separate vlog about this. How's that? Alright, so I'm on the opposite side of the bank from Tainalt's over that way. I'm at a car park at past Bonawe. If you don't know where Bonawe is, just check the map. This is the what I was looking for. It's a right of way to Loch Etive, so that's the way you go. You also have to pass the quarry. So that will be the route through this way to the quarry. And so I'll check the map for mileage, and we'll see what we've got to do. A long distance walk from here, well, it's 6.5 miles from here right to, it's about 8.5 miles to Connell, which is a fair old distance. So I could bring the car, park it here, and walk to King's House and then walk back again. Well, that was very random. I spotted the old school here on my way down to the, you know, through Bonawe. I thought I must pop in on the way back and get myself a coffee. And then I realised I didn't have any bloody cash. I said, I bet you don't take car payments. She says, no. She says, look, what did you want? And I says, oh, I'd feel dreadful. She says, get yourself a coffee and some cake. So lemon drizzle cake here. A beautiful coffee, real coffee, coffee beans. I had a good old chat, and she says, next time you're passing, I said, I will be passing, because I'm going to be walking that route from Bonawe up to King's House sometime. And she said, well, that's fine. So we had a good chat. I told her I was up at the church service, and she said, that's incredible. I said, it was more incredible than actually the chap that I met there previously recognised me right away. It was fabulous. I mean, as soon as I walked in, he goes, hello again. I thought, well, he's got a good memory. I recognise him as well, right enough. But then the minister himself on the way out says, I told him my story. He says, that's amazing. Thank you so much for doing that. That's amazing you come all that way. So it kind of, I think the one at Bridge of Orkney when I travelled up by bus on a Sunday just to get to the service and back again the same day was probably more extraordinary, actually. But let me switch this camera off and enjoy my cake and coffee while the coffee's still hot, you know. All right, so I've pulled in. I'm on the road to Ballyhoolish now, but that's Ardnamurchan over there. And Loch Linney. But what do you call it? I came over from Bonawe over the, how do you pronounce it, Berchaldin, over the mountain pass. It was actually all right. I thought it was going to be a struggle, but no, it was all right. And only met about five cars oncoming, so it was not too bad. A lot of people were up at the top, believe it or not. It must have been locals, of course, with their rolling their Easter eggs, you know, the boiled Easter eggs. We used to do that as children. Mum would boil up all these eggs, and then we'd paint them. Then we'd go and roll them, and then crack them open and eat them. It was magical. But that view out there is stupendous, it really is. It's actually quite pleasantly warm in that sunshine, when the sun does appear. But the roads are quite quiet. Well, this route is not bad. I've seen it a lot worse. It's been Sunday, of course, but being Easter Sunday, I thought there'd be a lot of camper vans and stuff all about, but they must all be holed up somewhere, you see. But you get background traffic. It is the main route to Fort William from Oban, you see. I thoroughly enjoyed all my trips. I mean, it's unbelievable, but Ardnamurchan, you know, I've walked right across the whole damn thing. It's amazing. More on the other side, you see, it's from the lighthouse right to Salon and right up to Loch Eilert and onwards. Loch Moidart. Yeah, all good, ain't it? So let's get a cigarette, oh, eh? Keep our spirits up high. This is looking down to the top of Glencoe. Glencoe village is down in there. There's still a bit of snow on the Glencoe mountains. And from Glencoe, you can go down to Kinlochleven. But it's beautiful. Truly beautiful, ain't it? So that's the Ballyhoolish Bridge. I can still remember the ferry crossing. We used to go on the car. I used to go on a ferry and take it over there. And you can still see the little ferry park there. That down there is the village of Glencoe, and you'll probably hear the traffic on the busy A82. It's been quite deafening. When I first came up here in this direction, I mean, literally, you had probably about 10 cars an hour, but it's 10 cars a bloody minute now. Down there is the Isles of Glencoe Hotel, owned by Crieff Hydro. They also own the Ballyhoolish Hotel. Now, when I stayed at the Ballyhoolish Hotel, November 22, I think it was, was it November 21? No, it could have been earlier than that, I can't remember, Andy. November 19? No, it wasn't then, I don't remember, sorry. But anyway, behind that, you see the quarry works. That's the slate quarries of Ballyhoolish. And as I said in a previous upload, Ballyhoolish slate is probably the most popular and most important slate outside of the Welsh valleys and the mountains there. Looking over to the Papa Glencoe, and this is Loch Leven, which takes you down to Kinloch Leven. That's the Mamors at the back there, and that's the way you go up through the pass on the West Highland Way for Fort William. Very difficult terrain, and I've walked up at the back of that at Blackwater Dam in a frightful time. It's all very good. I don't know if you can hear me above the wind, I'm sorry about this. Well, I've pulled in because to this lay-by because the absolute bloody lunatics on this road. The time I've pulled in and got my camera organised, most of the lunatics have passed. But I mean, somebody tried to overtake me there, and I could see the Audi coming up already overtaking him. And he pulled out in front of the bloody Audi. I don't know how they didn't collide, I've no idea. He managed to get back in behind me, but he was pretty close. But they're complete imbeciles on this road. And what doesn't help is the road itself. I mean, where I'm pointing the camera seems all right, but you ought to see this is a main trunk road, A82, and it's an absolute disgrace. I'm not joking you. It's really, really bad. So, I wouldn't like to be a biker on this route. It's been a great drive from Bonawe up to north of Benderloch and up by, you know, Appin and up to Ballyhoolish and down to Glencoe Village and stuff. I didn't snap. I went up to Clackie again, not for any refreshments, just a vantage point to get some footage, you know, on my mobile phone. But anyway, that's that contingency of lunatics has passed. It's 4:30. The last day of March, it's absolutely gorgeous. This is exactly the same sort of day. I think I mentioned it on one of the vlogs from Glencoe here when I came up here in 1978 and carrying a staff. But the conditions are exactly the same. I remember that day so clearly. And there must be a dip in the road because every time I look in my mirror, the cars that are coming southbound all just look like they're going to bloody plough into the back of me. It's So there must be a dip there. It's pushing the cars to the onto the verge side, do you? But anyway, they probably think I'm a speed cop here with this bloody camera pointed at their noses, but that's all the way out over Rannoch Moor to Shehalion. It's a long way out to Shehalion from here. It's wonderful. Great countryside, eh? And the snow, there's plenty of snow in the mountains. It's really beautiful. Especially around Glencoe there. Pulled into the Ardchattan lay-by here. Well, Macarras Bray to be precise. But between Comrie and Crieff. But it's the last lay-by I've got before I get home. And the reason I pulled in is it's been such a beautiful day. A tremendously memorable Easter. And I'm so pleased I made the decision yesterday to head up to Connell and stay overnight at the Falls of Laura Hotel. And, I didn't sleep terribly well. I probably only had about 3 hours sleep. But I know that drinking coffee, a very strong coffee at 20 past nine was the wrong idea. But still, I'm all right. But everything about the stay was fabulous. And then, of course, I was there in good time for the church service at Tain Ilt, which was my mission, of course. That's what the decision was, to go up to Argyllshire for. And it was so fantastic that the the gentleman I met the last time when I was at the kirk and the door was open, he was only there for 5 minutes to assist the fire officer, the inspector, and he allowed me kindly to have a look around the church inside. And of course, he recognised me. I recognised him. I think I said this earlier in one of my chats. But anyway, it was fabulous. And all the fiddlers on the stage, all playing their musical instruments, it was tremendous. And the minister, of course, who I obviously never met, but he'd done a very, very decent service. And we sung about 7 hymns altogether, which is probably a record for me at any Church of Scotland service, even for Easter. And on the way out, I gave him a brief rundown of the story that I'd come to Tain Ilt once and I'd promised to come back for a service. And I made the decision it would be for Easter because there was no services down my part of the world. And he thought that was tremendous. And it was so good. And everybody I've met today has been so kindly. Not just because of the sunny weather, but it's just the people I've met today have been so joyous and high vibrational. And I've really felt it. It's been a great, great day. I'm so pleased. And, so this is the first night of British summertime. And obviously the daylight's going to last till, 8 o'clock or more now. And I don't really want to be home too early in the evening, that's one thing, but it's been a long day, of course, and as I say, I've been up since what time? Give the clocks going forward, I was up at 7:10, I think it was, this morning, and I didn't really get to sleep until about 3:15, it was 4:20 on my watch. So it was 3:15, but I put the watch forward. So it was 4:20 was the last time I saw my wristwatch before I finally got some sleep. It's nothing to do with the pillows or the. I opened the window right enough because I don't like a warm bedroom. But anyway, I'm sure it was just the coffee had excited my brain. Perhaps it was that whiskey, it was through the Cranachan. I was talking a lot about that last night, the Cranachan sweet pudding. But anyway, I've come down that lunatic road, because I drove up to Ballyhoolish and came down by the Glencoe way, and it was crazy. It really was absolutely insane today. But hopefully everybody's got home safely, and that's the main thing. But
I do wish they would have a bit more patience on that road. I really do. I think they're a bit silly when it comes to you know, saving 5 minutes of time, because that's all they ever do. But the time you meet them again at Tyndrum, they'll race ahead and overtake on corners and everything, and then you meet them in the traffic queue at Tyndrum. It's bloody stupid. But I really have had a fantastic day, and it's lovely to see everything. And all the birds are so happy today. That's one thing I noticed. Everything from the crows to the sparrows to the chaffinches, is it all? And the ducks, and every bird I saw today, I had a chat with, they were absolutely over the moon about the sunshine. And just like humans, they've shrugged off that long, dreary, damp, horrible, wet winter we've had. It's just been awful for 6 months or more. That's, anyway, I won't say too much, because we all have to split all these vlogs into kind of sort of random pieces and, you know, part one to such and such. It's just my way of breaking up the broadcast, rather than try and knit it all together and put it up in one or two segments, because the truth is it takes so damn long to get it loaded onto my editing suite. It's it takes forever. So that's one of the reasons I don't do it in 45-minute segments anymore. It takes about 16 hours to load it. But anyway, it's just a beautiful day, and I'm very pleased to be making the journey home. I'd be glad to get in the house, to be honest. Despite the daylight, I'd be glad just to, you know, be in my own home fireside, so to speak. So thanks very much for listening to all my stories from Easter weekend. Thank you.